الحمد لله وحده، والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله، الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله، الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رحمة للعالمين. Respected علماء، وفاد يا بزراد السيستس، بزراد يانس لسنس، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Many thanks to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has indeed granted us the ability to be here today, alhamdulillah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our presence, inshaAllah, ameen, thumma ameen. Jamaat al-Muslimin, alhamdulillah, I am very pleased today, as I've been trying for many weeks to get our guest speaker here today. And alhamdulillah, we are very fortunate that we have him here today, alhamdulillah. Jamaat al-Muslimin, the Mawla of today, Jamaat al-Muslimin, is a very energetic imam, very energetic alim, the founder of Cape Town Islamic Educational Center, and is also the principal. Not only that, is the deputy principal of the Sunni Ulama Council. Alhamdulillah, Mawlana is a lot of activities that Mawlana is partaking in, alhamdulillah. Just this morning, Mawlana has distributed bread and rolls and so on to the needy. And this is what Mawlana is doing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala must grant Mawlana a long life with barakah and khair, inshallah. Amen. Thumma amen. So without any delay, I would like to call upon Mawlana Sayyid Imran Shah Ziyai. فليتفضل.
بارك الله. الفاتحة من الله، صلى على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما تحب. اللهم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. رب زدني علما وارزقني فهما، وارحمنا يا كريم، وارحم أمة محمد المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل محمد وبارك وسلم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. وأحسن منك لم تر قط عيني يا رسول الله، وأجمل منك لم تلد النساء يا رسول الله، خلقت مبرأ من كل عيب يا رسول الله، كأنك قد خلقت كما تشاء يا رسول الله. Respected most honorable elders, ulama, tulaba, students of the deen, brothers, innocent youth, mothers, sisters, and all those that are joining us throughout the globe. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, Mawlana Sahib mentioned some words in my praise and honor. We make dua, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us to be able to live according to the good thoughts of people. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us humble to serve. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from pride and arrogance. Alhamdulillah, it is not because of our own action that we are somebody. Being on various platforms, alhamdulillah, and fadl of Allah, various institutions, various boards, in total comfortably more than 15 different institutions, we try to assist in whichever way we can. However, it's not because we are somebody. Hada min fadli rabbi. This is from the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us. How Allah gives, Allah can take. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us that we are able to inshaAllah serve. And alhamdulillah, it is my honor to be present here today in this beautiful masjid. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant that each and every one of us have falah. May each and every one of us have success. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it a means of rahmah. It is not my arrogance that has kept me away from this masjid, but for more than 6 months, I am almost every week in a different city, and most of the time, almost every week, I'm flying, whether it be for Jum'ah or different program throughout South Africa, and inshallah in a few days time we leave out of the country as well. We make dua, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us steadfast on the deen. May we be from amongst those who realize without deen we are nothing. Everything is based upon our deen. And alhamdulillah, today's brief discussion will be based upon the Holy Quran and the Sunnah of the Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on a very pertinent and important topic. And that is, we're going to be speaking about the youth and a few challenges that are affecting them. The youth and a few challenges affecting the youth. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us hidayah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us taqwa. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instill in us the adherence of following the Quran and the Sunnah of the Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah, my very good friend, colleague, and alhamdulillah, a personality that is also an advisor to me at times, and he's well known to you, alhamdulillah, Mawlana Sarfaraz Hamza. We had the opportunity, alhamdulillah, in our life that we studied together, and alhamdulillah, we also went to Pakistan to further our studies together. And about just over a year ago, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested us that on the same Jum'ah, at the same time, on the Jum'ah in the morning, his mom had passed on. And I told him, Maulana, don't go to the masjid, I will go in your place. My mother is still alive. You go and be with your family. And whilst I was standing on the mimbar, I received message that my mother had passed on. It was indeed the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that our mothers also left on the same day, on the day of Jum'ah. We make dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite us solely only for His pleasure. So alhamdulillah, since the masajid is filled with lovers of Allah and lovers of the beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it is my first time ever in this masjid, so I feel, let us inshallah take maybe half a minute or maybe 33 seconds if we can, inshallah, in the praise of the beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is a great qasida, and this is known as qasida al-burda. And burda was written by Imam Busayri rahmatullah. And when, at the time when this Imam and this Sheikh felt that the doctors, he was starting to get certain sickness, that he was paralyzed, he couldn't move. And so, and from his waist downwards, he couldn't feel. So it's only his hands and, you know, few movement, but he was having difficulty. And so he went to the doctors and they said to him, sorry, sir, time is up. We can't help you anymore. Finish this. This is the end of the line. We can't do anything much. And so he was a devotee in the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he started writing, Alhamdulillahilladhi. And he started writing the shi'rs or the stanzas of Burda. And so much so that when he slept, he had a dream of none other than Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he sees the beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his dream. And the beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asks him, O Busayri, recite to me what you have written. And Imam Busayri starts and he's reciting. And when he's reciting, so much so that even the other people that were in the dream, all of them enjoyed this beautiful recitation. The beloved sallallahu alaihi wasallam takes his mantle. Hey, he takes his covering. He takes his shawl for us, for our understanding purposes. And he places it on Imam Busayri. And Imam Busayri wakes up. And when he wakes up, he finds miraculously, because everything happens with the power of Allah. But he finds miraculously that that burda of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is on his bed. And he hears a knock on the door. And he goes towards the door. And when he goes, he realizes that now he can go himself to the door. And the people are standing in a line. Oh Busayri, we also want those couplets that you recited last night in the presence of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Imam Busayri received shifa from Allah, but through the praising of the beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So inshallah, few moments in the praise of the beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for it is the tradition of the pious, and I'm very far from there. But the pious, they would always, when they start something good, after Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, and after praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they would recite few stanzas of burda, including my ustad, Muslih Ummat, Abu al-Khair, Sheikh Sayyid Haseenuddin, who is a great personality, currently, with no exaggeration, in charge of over 5 million students every year. And he has various institutions that is running throughout the world, including one that Maulana Zaid comes from, as well as myself, the Darul Uloom Pretoria. It is important. And he mentions and he says, when you start something good, after Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, recite few stanzas for the purpose of barakah in your life. So we are going to recite it with this intention. It is the new year. It is the month of Muharram al-Haram. And it is the first time I'm in your masjid. And it is a beautiful opportunity on the day of Jum'ah. So let us take a few moments, inshaAllah. Mawlaya salli wa sallim daiman أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم محمد سيد الكونين والثقلين والفريقين من عرب ومن عجم مولاي صل وسلم دائما ابدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. الحمد لله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states to us in the Holy Quran in various verses about how we should constantly assist towards good. تعاونوا على البر والتقوى. How we must encourage and how we must hasten towards goodness and piety, and how we should forbid ourselves from doing anything that will earn the wrath of Allah or the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I'm not here to teach you of that, because every single person knows that. But we need to base our teachings upon the Holy Quran, so no one feels it is flowery talk. It is just something from hawa. Everything that we say must be from the Quran and the Sunnah. And then we know that that is authentic. Every person has to accept it, because it is what Allah says and what the beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. So we learn from this verse of the Holy Quran. And also we understand from the hadith of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لا يؤمنوا. You will not be a believer until you love for your Muslim brother what you love for yourself. Haq. Until you love for your Muslim brother what you love for yourself. And the verses of the Holy Quran, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. You will never attain success. Who is saying this? Allah. Quran, who is the narrator of the Quran? Allah. He gives it to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to mention to us. But the Quran comes from Allah. And what is the Quran? The Quran is that book, Hudan lil Muttaqeen. It is a guidance for those who are Allah conscious. So some people, and when we come to Muttaqeen, a lot of people translate, and I'm not here to give fatwa, I'm not a mufti. People say it is God-fearing. Alhamdulillah, those that translate God-fearing, Allah reward them. But I feel an appropriate translation. Please listen carefully. I'm not saying God-fearing is incorrect. I'm saying an appropriate translation would be Allah-conscious. Why? Because I feel it's important that we don't only fear Allah. I feel it's important that we love Allah. I feel it's important that we build a communication and we build a connection with Allah. It's important for us to become close to Allah, and you can't come close to someone that you fear. So you must be close to Allah. We fear the parameters that is set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we love Allah. And so when we say muttaqin, we must be Allah conscious. So guidance is for those who are Allah conscious. Those who reflect that there is an Allah, there is a Allah. Those that reflect that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in charge of our being. So the Quran, la rayba fi. There is no doubt in it. There is no doubt in it. La rayba fi. So in this Holy Quran, Allah Himself says, no matter who you are, you can be a CEO, you can be the Malik, you can be in charge, you can be whoever. Know very well that you will never attain success until you spend from that which you love from that which I have given you. Allah is clear. So the point of these verses of the Quran and the Hadith is we are currently in a situation where do not wait for an earthquake, do not wait for a tsunami, do not wait for some type of disaster that's going to take away our ummah. We are already in a state of disaster when it comes to our iman, when it comes to our a'mal, when it comes to our actions. And I'm not generalizing, but majority. Has it not become apparent to us? Is it not that we go now to a janaza and our children don't know how to make dua? We go to a janaza and the people don't know how to even read a talqeen? We go to a janaza and the people don't know how to give ghusl? Who is responsible? Since when has it become the duty that you have to have a burial society and they have to wash my father's body? No, they can assist me, and we live in a time where we should assist each other. But we should know it is our duty. When my father passes away, I must be there to be able to pour water upon him. But we don't learn this. And if we learn it, we take it like it is just a joke. So unfortunately, it comes to a time where we have these problems. And that is why I can't address every problem that is facing youth. But because I'm youth, And I feel, you know, before 50, you have to be youth. So, you know, it is important that we still have life. And we must be able to enjoy that life. But we must follow the Quran and the Sunnah. So what are some of the things that are affecting our youth? We know the normal things, you know, that everyone would just, we have drugs, we have, you know, lots of other sicknesses. But I'm speaking of more the moral problems. Respect is a major concern. And I'm not saying you must abuse the children, no. There's no abuse. But you know, before parents would discipline children. Today, children are disciplining parents. Today, it is a state where you can't say anything to a child. If you say something to a child, no. You have to first have, before you could say to your child what you wanted. Now you must first go, close the door, speak with your wife and talk, okay, how are we going to approach this situation? What are we going to do? What are we going to say? No, because we must know how to talk. Just now we hurt his heart or we hurt her heart. She hang herself. So we must know. We must be able. So they got us so wrapped around the finger that we can't do nothing. Please, if you have cell phones, I humbly request, put it to silent mode. The reality is, we have such situations. Our children today are swearing. Just last week, I was in a case where I tried so much to help this mother, but her son was beating her with a belt. And everyone yelled, say, Allahu Akbar. He wasn't a Christian, he was a Muslim. And you know what happened? I went and I did what I had to do, and eventually I ended up at the police station because the same mother charged me. And she had to explain to me in tears, Sheikh, I didn't want to charge you. But if I never charge you, my son will kill me. So please, I drop all charges, he must go. This is the life. If you're not living that life, make shukr to Allah. But there are many, many old parents, senior citizens, that are being abused by their own children. And this is a reality. Today, me and you, if we have little wealth, we feel we are rich. You're not rich because of your money. You must be rich because of the du'as of your parents. You must be rich because of the du'as of your parents. Wallah, I don't have a father, I don't have a mother, both is in the qabr. But I will pay anything just to see them once. You have them. You don't honor them. How many of us are so drowned in our rat race that we don't have time? Some people, I was at a person, I won't mention names, I was at a person in KwaZulu-Natal last week. And she spoke to me, an old lady. And she says, Sheikh, I don't want his money. I just want some time that he must pick up the phone to talk to me. I just want some time he must pick up the phone to find out. I just want to hear his voice. How sad is that? The mother who kept you in her womb for 9 months. The mother who was ready to give away her beauty. The mother that was ready to even give her life at the time whilst giving birth. That mother we don't have time for. We become so busy in our rat race that we can't go. There's so many people. I know of a person lately, 3 months ago, he passed on. Allahu Akbar. He stays in the house. His children stay with him in the house. But because he became old and became, you know, when they get old, they start getting also fussy and problematic and everything starts to affect them. So the family left him one side in his own house. And when he passed away, the door was closed. 1 day, 2 days, on the third day when the smell started coming, then they broke down the door to only find that their father has passed on. We maybe all will think, but how is this possible? Allah forbid, but some of us are guilty of it. We don't have time to phone our mother. We became so rich that we don't go and see them. We became so powerful that we embarrassed to be amongst them. What has become of us? That small hamster that carries on running in a cage is better than me and you. If that is our behavior, have we forgotten the hadith of the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, huma jannatuka wa naruka? The parents are your jannat or jahannam, depending how you will treat them. You will go to paradise or you will suffer. Today we've become doctors and we become lawyers and we become, I got nothing against professions. We became ulama. But we don't know how to do justice to our parents. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us that we can make a amal upon the ilm. No sheikh, no matter how great he might be, no sheikh is bigger than the rights of your parents. When there's a sheikh, we can kiss his hands, we can go, mashallah, mashallah, sheikh, I'm so big sheikh. But our mother, our father, we just walk away. They gave you life. They were there for you when no one knew you. When no one even knew you. At the time when they had to wipe and they had to wash, they had to take away from you impurity, they sacrificed their life. Today you become so big, you forgot who is your parents. So many big business people, even if they're talking to their mother, they meet their friend, they will never introduce, this is my mother. Because she don't look like the mother of a big millionaire. No. Don't forget, your parents maybe never have degree, but they had Allah consciousness. They never have degrees. They never go to university. They never go to college. They worked very hard so that you can go to college, not so that you can disrespect them. So there's a major concern amongst the youth. Until you don't realize that your parents are more important than you, you are useless. Without your parents, you are nothing. And we do these things. I know Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned walk behind the parents. We walk in front of them. Don't call the parents by their name. We call them by their name. Adab. This respect has been lost. Before, if we sat, I come, I sit there in the lounge. My father has some guests. He's talking to his friends. My duty is to be quiet. Today, a father is speaking to his friends. Your son is coming inside. He's also giving tarjuma. He's also making tafsir. He also can speak. It's all, we're friends. So it's not my father's friend, he's my friend now also. The sense of adab is lost. Children smoking in front of their parents. Children bringing their girlfriends and doing other activity in front of their parents. They have no shame. What that old uncle and old auntie is going to say? What they're going to do? They can't do anything. If we open our mouth, our son won't give the check. If we open our mouth, he won't buy this for us. So we must keep quiet. What are we going to do? That is the life. And that is what's affecting the youth. That is the biggest tsunami and the biggest disaster. We have various other problems. Be it even if you have to tell them something. Take example, I don't know your masjid, is the first time I'm here. But majority, if you go on a Jum'ah outside, you'll find the youth. The outside. Nowadays it's gone where the adults also joining the youth. Instead of setting example, they became the different part. But when you say something to someone, who are you? You're not my father. You don't tell me what to do. But don't be scared, don't be sad. Even if his father told him, he wouldn't listen. Because today, when your father says something, it means nothing. There was a time, you know, I always remember, we came up from very humble beginnings. So, you know, Strawberry World Biscuit, you know, I don't work for bakers, I'm not advertising for them, but I'm just saying, Strawberry World Biscuit, now they don't make it how they used to. It used to be very tasty. You know, And it used to be there whenever visitors come. Today people have changed. When visitors come, you sit there 1 hour also, they don't offer you water. You need an appointment, and even with the appointment you don't get water. Not that you're going to someone's house for something. But before, the elderly will teach you. When someone walks in your house, they bringing barakah to your house. They must not leave without something. So when that strawberry biscuit come out, you must know visitors are coming. And now we wait. Every time I'm looking at that biscuit, but I can't touch it. If I touch it and the visitors are there, my mother, she will just look once. That eyes, subhanallah. After that, I understood properly. Because otherwise, if your father touches you on the top of your head, you feel it through the whole body. This was life. Today you tell a child, don't take the biscuit. Oh, mommy, why are you looking at me? Why I can't take the biscuit? There's no sense of adab. It's lost. And who is responsible? Me and you. Because when the child is 2 years old and the child is swearing, then we say, see how cute the child. Did you hear that? How the child saw? We go put it on TikTok and everywhere. Hey, this child is swearing. When he's 16 years old and he swear you, then it's not so cute. This is the reality. We are taking them away from Allah. And we will be responsible on the day of Qiyamah. For the hadith of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, every single one of us will be questioned upon our flock. We are responsible. Safeguard ourselves and safeguard our family from the fire of Jahannam. We only spoke about one major thing that is affecting the youth. I never yet go into peer pressure, I never yet go into other problems, I never yet go into drugs, I never even go into stealing, there's so much. But if we do the groundwork, everything else will improve. And that comes from the beautiful understanding, رِضَ اللَّهِ فِي رِضَ الْوَالِدَيْ. The pleasure of Allah lies in the pleasure of respecting the parents. If this can happen, then alhamdulillah, the way is going. But you can't tell your 10-year-old go to the masjid when yourself you watching TV. You can't tell the 10-year-old don't lie when yourself you are lying. They say, what about ghibah? What has become of us? We invite people, they're at our house. The moment your brother leaves from there, now you start speaking with your wife, you start speaking about ill, not good, ill about your brother, about his family, about how you expect that child to respect you when you yourself in front of him is disrespecting your brother. Have you forgotten? That day, it is, you know, they learn from what they see. If you behave in that manner, that's how they're going to behave. Therefore, it is very important. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant me and grant you the strength and ability to act upon the Holy Quran and the Sunnah of the Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There's so much lack of confidence, hopelessness. Youth don't know how to use their time. They don't know how to use their time. They need time management. Little they have to study, they need tablets, they need to... the child is stressed out, the child is... Every child is stressed out. That time we couldn't be stressed. You didn't know what was stress. You had to still do the chores at home. You had to still go to school, come back, rush, get to the madrasa. The apa, muallima, muallim speak bad about you. You catch it on top of that. You come home, you have to still do your work. Then you start homework. Then you're so tired, there was no time even for TV. That was life. Today, no, I'll do it just now. I'm watching this episode first. That series, this, everything else has controlled our life. What is our situation? We make dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, firstly protect me and protect you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, keep us guided. I don't want to take too much time. I was told, Sheikh, you can speak, inshallah, till quarter past, but I think quarter past is going to be too long. So I'm going to, inshallah, finish at 1:11. For Mona Zaid will tell you, I like the number 11 from I'm very, very young. So inshallah, we'll conclude on another occasion. We will speak and we will learn from the Quran and the Sunnah. Remember, we must be from those that love Allah, for Allah loves us. Allah loves us. Allah is waiting for us to ask for forgiveness so that Allah can forgive us. That is another topic. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless each and every one of you. It is indeed on behalf of the Sunni Ulama Council Cape Town, as well as the Cape Town Islamic Educational Center. It is our honor to be present here today for Jumu'ah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it a means of rahmah. And may we soon visit you again, inshallah. Jumu'ah Mubarak to each and every one of you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
MashaAllah, subhanAllah, we say JazakAllah to Mawlana for the beautiful nasiha. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant Mawlana and his entire family long life with barakah and khayr, success in this world and the year after, inshallah. Ameen, thumma ameen. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to install in our children's hearts the Quran and the Sunnah and teach them good character, inshallah. Ameen, thumma ameen. Few announcements. We will be having the completion of our monthly khatam al-Quran on Thursday 25th August immediately after Isha. We appeal to all, and particularly the community of Baabul South and surrounding areas, to attend. Once again, a reminder for of the adult classes Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday evenings after Jumu'ah. Due to the khatam al-Quran program on Thursday, the hadith classes presented by Hafid Muhammad Asad will inshallah move to Monday 29th August after Isha. We make dua for Muallima Yasmin, who commemorated her birthday yesterday. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant her lots of barakah and khair in the world in the year after, inshallah. Ameen, thumma ameen. And all those who have birthdays, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them long life with barakah and khair. Do support the food sales in the garage after Jumu'ah. Your support will be highly appreciated. The executive committee, once again, thank everyone for their continued support of the masjid. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا مولانا محمد وبارك وسلم فيا أيها المؤمنون رحمنا ورحمكم الله تعالى أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل في السر والإعلان واذكروا الله عند كل شجر وحجر واعلموا أن الله بما تعملون بصير وأن الله ليس بغافل عما تعملون فإن سني الأنوار وزينوا قلوبكم بحب هذا النبي الكريم عليه الصلاة والتسليم ألا لا إيمان لمن لا محبة له ألا لا إيمان لمن لا محبة له ألا لا إيمان لمن لا محبة له رزقنا الله تعالى وإياكم بحب هذا النبي الكريم عليه الصلاة والتسليم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا مولانا محمد وبارك وسلم بارك الله لنا ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعنا وإياكم بالآيات وذكر الحكيم إنه تعالى ملك كريم جواد بر الرؤوف الرحيم اللهم صل وسلم على محمد وعلى آل محمد الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا وحبيبنا وغوثنا وغياسنا ومغيثنا ومعيننا وقطبنا وسراجنا ونظامنا وأشرفنا وراحة قلوبنا نور من نور الله محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا حبيبي يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وصحابك يا رحمة للعالمين لا سيما على أمير المؤمنين سيدنا أبا بكر الصديق رضي الله تعالى عنه وعلى أمير المؤمنين سيدنا عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه وعلى أمير المؤمنين سيدنا عثمان بن عفان رضي الله تعالى عنه وعلى أمير المؤمنين سيدنا علي بن أبي طالب كرم وجهه الكريم وعلى ابنيه الكريمين أبي محمد الحسن وأبي عبد الله الحسين رضي الله تعالى عنهما وعلى أمهما سيدة النساء من أهل الجنة فاطمة الزهراء رضي الله تعالى عنها وعلى سائر الصحابة أجمعين اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار آمين 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 اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم احفظنا من الحسد والرياء واحفظنا من الفقر والزنا واحفظنا من الغيبة والفتنة واحفظنا من كل أعمال السيئات وأعمال الشيطان الرجيم اللهم نور قلوبنا بنور الإيمان وبنور الإسلام وبالهداية القرآن وبسنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. ربنا يا مولانا واجعلنا منهم واغذل من قدر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ربنا يا مولانا ولا تجعلنا منهم عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يعملكم العدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأولى وأجل وأتم وأهم وأعظم وأكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون أقم الصلاة Inshallah, if we can fill the gaps as quick as possible, please come forward. Shoulder to shoulder, try our best to keep our soft straight. May Allah give us long life, but if this is our last salah, how would you perform it? Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. والشمس وضحاها والقمر إذا تلاها والنهار إذا جلاها والليل إذا يغشاها والسماء وما بناها والأرض وما طحاها ونفس وما سواها فألهمها فجورها وتقواها. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. قد أفلح من زكاها وقد خاب من دساها كذبت ثمود بطغواها إذ انبعث أشقاها فقال لهم رسول الله ناقة الله وسقياها فكذبوه فعقروها فدمدم عليهم ربهم بذنبهم فسواها ولا يخاف عقباها. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله من كل ذنب واتوب اليه. امين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى ال سيدنا مولانا محمد وبارك وسلم. Oh Allah, safeguard us from your wrath and your anger. Make us from amongst those that follow Holy Quran. Make us from amongst those that perform our five times salah wa jamaat. Ya Rahman, Ya Kareem, forgive us of the sins we commit knowingly and the sins we commit unknowingly. Oh Allah, if you have to judge us, then judge us with your mercy and not your justice. For we are the ummati of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Rahman, Ya Kareem, we beg of you, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, shower your blessings and your bounties upon us. Grant our family and grant each and every one of us salvation. Ya Rahman, Ya Kareem, safeguard us from any type of pandemic, any type of sickness, any type of illness. Ya Rahman, Ya Kareem, make us from amongst those that are successful. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala al-Nabi. Ya ayyuhal ladhina aminu sallu alayhi wa sallimu wa taslima. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina maulana Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad wa barik wa sallim. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yusifun. Wa salamun ala al-mursaleen. والحمد لله رب العالمين بحق لا إله إلا الله. جمعة مبارك.
الحمد لله. دعاء فرما إن شاء الله. عايز تاس إن شاء الله هو جاي.